Mm-hmm. You all make good points. Rational, Adrian. What about you, though? Me? Yes, you. You're the reason we're in this mess in the first place.
chatnoir/recklessadrian.
I don't know, but can we really call it a mess? I mean...
Okay, slowly add in the eggs. Wait!
It's so much fun.
Night 5.
Oh, it's 11 PM already.
Oh, already? That was fast. I'll clean up here. You can go home. Thanks again, Marinette. Are you sure you don't want help? Don't you have to get up early for school or anything?
Get up.
Ugh. 5 AM. Well, I'm used to operating on not enough sleep.
5:30 AM.
Look alive, this is the sunrise shoot.
Chugging coffee.
Oh, I didn't know that. Can I ask you something?
Sure, what is it?
Why did you make the bet with Ladybug? I mean, I understand getting carried away, but if you didn't know how to bake anything, let alone something like a show... Wait, if that sounded like I don't want to help you, it's not...
No, I get it. It doesn't really make sense. I'm surprised you waited this long to ask, actually. I think it might be because, in my civilian life, I do lots of things. Things I've always done and have to be good at. I like them well enough, but I didn't choose any of it for myself. So when Ladybug said I couldn't bake, well, she was right. But I wanted to, and I'm really bad, but I like it that way. Doing something even if I'm bad just because I want to, and working hard to improve just because I want to. I've never done it before. It's hard, and I like it.
Huh? Hold on!
Well, I overshared.
I think it's admirable how you're not afraid of trying something you're not good at. Honestly, I tend to give up if I'm not perfect from the start, even though that's not realistic. So I guess what I'm trying to say is... I'm glad you did the best.
Even if it was a bit foolish to do so.
You ruined the moment. You know, Tiki, I was surprised to hear Chad has such high expectations in real life. He also said he's used to sleeping less. Do you think he has strict parents? You have no idea. It's possible. Maybe that's why he acts so carefree as Chad. I didn't know. I thought he was always goofy.
Pun. You're on.
No wonder he latched onto the bet. How often does he get to have fun? Even so.
Marinette, I did it.
Did what?
Look, the butter and sugar is just melted and slightly brown. I didn't burn it.
Oh, it's perfect.
Really?
He's working hard for this bet. I'll do my best, too.
Phew. Do you transform me, Plague? Zap.
You owe me 7 truckloads of cheese tomorrow.
Don't... Be so dramatic.
70 truckloads.
I'm gonna wash up and go right to bed. Today was also lots of fun. I'm improving little by little thanks to Marinette. I'm tired, but I'm so happy. I'm excited for our next lesson.
Natalie. Adrian, your father and I are returning a few days ahead of schedule. Natalie, we'll be arriving home while you are at school. So be prepared for your father when we get home. Adrian, your father and I are returning a few days ahead of schedule. We'll be arriving while you are at school, so be prepared to greet your father when you get home. Meanwhile,
come on people, pack it up! Dream Adrian will be here any second. Chad, stop being distracted by a speck of dust. Rebellious, please don't drag your beanbag like that. And can you please stop that, just a friend? Marinette is so nice and kind and pretty. Marinette is such a good teacher and she's so helpful and so much fun and she's a good friend. Oh, sorry. I was busy doing this as we shut down for the night. Well, just pack it up, please, or you might affect Dream Adrian's work. Who's there? Weird. I guess I was imagining it. But aren't I a figment of imagination? Whatever.
The next day, 9 AM.
We're here, sir. Should I drop your things off in your office?
Yes. Set up my desk as well. I won't be in my office until later.
Huh? You're going to akumatize?
No, I'm just going to see her. Don't come down.
They sent a package for Adrian. I'll drop this off first. Huh? What is that?
Avenue 2100. 52 Avenue de Presse, every night, 9 PM. Come ready.
I don't recognize this address. This isn't Adrian's handwriting either.
Baking basics. Aerate flour. Packing flour leads to too much, causing density and dryness. Mix around or spin into a mess. Or spoon into cup. Room temperature.
100M temperature ingredients. Simmers in trapped air, fluffier bakes. Don't overcook. Or 2, use mixed moisture to rise. Don't cook out moisture from butter and eggs.
Thorough notes on baking? What has Adrian been up to?
Natalie? Father? You've arrived back already?
I sent you a message. Did you not see it?
The notification must have gotten buried. No. Adrian, we need to speak.
A business deal?
Yes. As you're aware, I was in Italy the past few days negotiating a deal with an Italian fashion brand. The deal went through. So you, as the face of the Gress brand, are to fly to Italy this coming weekend to shoot advertisements for their brand. You won't miss any school. So, any objections?
That's the weekend after my bet with Ladybug on Friday. I won't be missing it if I go.
No, Father. I can do it. Good. Your flight will be on Friday night then. Natalie, see Adrian to his room.
Yes, sir.
That was all? Somehow I was expecting more.
Huh? So, Adrian, did you do anything interesting while we were gone?
Just school, Chinese piano, and fencing as usual.
Interesting? What's that supposed to mean? I see. Well, here we are. If you need anything, call for me.
Thank you.
Oh, and the Italian brand sent you a package too. I left it on your bed.
Alright, thank you, Natalie. Natalie was being a bit odd.
It's a bummer that the 2 stone statues are back so soon.
Don't say that, Plague.
What? It's true. You can't even give me extra cheese from the kitchen anymore.
Huh? That's weird. Where's the address sheet?
The what?
Marinette wrote down the address of the kitchen and gave it to me.
You mean you haven't memorized it yet? It's been like a week.
I have, but it should still be here, right?
Maybe your stone statue assistant took it.
Down here? Natalie?
Why not? She wasn't here to drop that package off, right?
Yeah, but she left it on my bed. She wouldn't come around to my desk for no reason. Besides, if Natalie saw, she'd have told Father and I'd be banned by now. It probably fell and one of the cleaning staff tossed it.
I could tell Gabriel, but notes on baking aren't solid proof that Adrian's been sneaking out. Further, if I were to go to Adrian's room tonight at 9 and it was empty, I'd be obligated to tell Gabriel. And Gabriel wouldn't take it lightly. He could even involve the police if he wanted. No, I'll do something else. The next night.
Congrats! I think you're officially ready to start practicing and making chill.
Really?
Yep, it's good timing too, since we're at the 1 week mark.
Hmm?
What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. I just realized we're halfway done.
Oh, you're right.
Somehow I forgot that this would only last for 2 weeks. Well, let's start.
Right, of course.